Hello, I'm Dr. Barry Brazelton. For families with seriously ill children, the choices for care have been limited to hospital and home nursing. However, today there's a third choice available, which offers considerable benefits to both medically fragile children and their families. The presentation you're about to see explores a unique concept in transitional care for medically fragile, technology-dependent children. It addresses both the physical demands of these children, but also their psychological and developmental needs. It offers relief from the financial burden of traditional care and provides the most normal lifestyle possible for both the child and the family. This is a place where people really care. This is a center for kids who have special needs. These are medically fragile, technology-dependent children who require quality, professional care. But unlike traditional methods, the care these children receive is in a home-like setting known as a Kangaroo Kids Center.
Well, actually, in 1987, the company started as a provider of pediatric nursing services in the home, at home. And those services were for children who had chronic long-term problems, or for some children on a short-term basis if they were post-surgery and needed some nursing care or some IV therapy. And then in 1989, basically as an outgrowth of the home care program, we created the Centers for Fragile Children. And the reason why they came to be is predominantly because when you're in the home, the nursing care and the medical care needs of the child were met. However, it was one-on-one, one nurse to one patient. The children were isolated in their home, and there were more than medical needs that needed to be met. There were the developmental needs of the child, especially for the chronically ill children. There was also socialization needs. If they're isolated in their home, there's no other children that they can relate to. They sometimes felt they were the only ones with a problem. And then their parents had just a tremendous amount of pressure put on them. There was no relief for them. And so an environment that would meet those needs was sort of conceptualized, and the centers were created.
Kangaroo Kids Centers provide care for children with a wide range of physical needs. The age for children under care at the facility ranges from infants to 18 years of age. The children are medically stable, but require therapy or nursing care.
Children that are called medically fragile or technology dependent have lots of different needs in terms of nursing needs and in terms of equipment needs. For example, there are children who are dependent on a ventilator. We can provide that here. There's a whole vast number of different types of infusion therapies children can require, whether it's on an intermittent basis, like they get it once or twice a day. Some children require it continuously. There's different feeding therapies that we do, and feeding therapy can run the gamut of teaching a child how to coordinate their suck and swallow with a bottle to placing tubes into their abdomen or to support their nutritional needs. We can provide nearly all the technology that's required to support a child in the center that you could get in the hospital. You know, with certain exceptions. Again, this is not an acute care setting, but this is a child that is medically fragile or technology dependent, meaning they're going to require it for a while, and we can provide that here in the center very safely.
As far as the facilities of the center are concerned, Kangaroo Kids offers the latest medical equipment and is staffed by highly skilled, compassionate nurses who have extensive experience in pediatric and neonatal care.
We have registered nurses, we have licensed vocational nurses, we have CNAs, nursing assistants, we have physical therapists who come in, we have a dietitian who comes in once a week. We also have the clinical nurse managers who we call on from time to time for questions that we can't answer, and who usually are on call at night for any questions.
Well, first of all, I think we have to understand that where you provide the care is simply four walls. You can have four walls and call it a hospital, or you can have four walls and call it a respite care center. What goes on in the center or in the hospital is what's important. Here at Kangaroo Kids, we have neonatal trained nurses. The majority of them are registered nurses. They all have neonatal experience. Myself and my colleagues are all board certified neonatologists. The babies are seen daily by a board certified neonatologist. The type of care provided is exactly the same standards as would be expected in a hospital. The standards that we follow are written by the American Academy of Pediatrics. We follow them to the letter, just as any hospital would do. The fact that we're not a hospital does not change the type of care that the baby gets. Now, should the extremely rare condition arise in which a baby would require acute hospitalization, an acute service hospital is 10 minutes away from this facility, in which I'm the director of the NICU. There are transport facilities are available. The doctor's available within 5 minutes. So should that need arise, acute hospitalization would be easy to obtain.
Center, for me, I feel very comfortable having Jason here, and that is just one less stress that I have in my life, knowing that he is being taken care of because he has so many medical needs that he's being taken care of. And we just had an instance not more than 2 months ago where had he not been at the center, he probably would have died. He had an extended seizure that caused some breathing problems. The nurse knew what to do, got a hold of my wife right away. We got him in the hospital, and it was a matter of probably an hour. Had he been anywhere else, I think he probably would not have made it. So it does, and when I go to work, when I leave the house and I know he's at the center, I'm very relieved.
I'm a flight attendant for Southwest Airlines, and I leave for two or three days at a time. Sometimes I have to overnight in different cities, and the center has been wonderful in that my schedule is very hectic. I leave for two or three days at a time, and I need a medical facility that will handle that type of a schedule. Kangaroo Kids is a great transitional center in that they're open 24 hours a day to take care of medically fragile children like Alexis. And they can watch her and care for her. I can give them less than 24 hours notice if I have to, and sometimes I can be on call and be called out to have to work. And I can just call someone at the office here and say I need to drop Alexis off for 3 days, and they'll set up all her medical needs and equipment and have her ready. And that's a big relief for me, because with this business, it's hard to think that I have to call someone and just get them there on a moment's notice and then explain everything. Here, the facility is, they know of all of Alexis's complications. They keep up with what she's doing on a regular basis, and I can drop her off on a moment's notice and know that she's going to be well taken care of.
It's simply too much stress for a family to tolerate a serious illness and a serious chronic illness in a child. At the center, we can relieve some of that stress. The children can be placed here. Parents can still be involved in care, but they don't have to be totally responsible. They can lead a more normal life. It's very important for fathers and mothers' relationship and for parents and other sibling relationships. There are many families will have normal siblings. Those kids tend to get left out when there is a medically dependent child at home. Here we can relieve parents for a while of that awesome responsibility, knowing that they can interact with the care here, and knowing that the care is excellent, then they can go on with their lives. It's not a way to abandon your child, it's a way to have somebody else shoulder the burden.
You're not going to be able to get care like this any other place. This is like home, and this is like an extended family to your child, and these people spend more time with your child than you do on a daily basis. And just the atmosphere, I can't imagine sending them anyplace else than what we did, and I'm very, very glad we did. This is absolutely the best that that this community can provide.
Quality of care is further enhanced by the atmosphere of the center itself. The brightly colored decor and cheerful furnishings provide a home-like appearance, contrasting to that of a traditional hospital setting.
Well, if you have a child that's sick, it's very stressful, and children are very sensitive to their environment. You won't see the nurses wearing crisp white uniforms. We often see our nurses wearing very casual clothes so that we can decrease any kind of stress possible for these children. They have a physiological reason. I mean, they've got a healthcare reason why they're not well today, and anything that we can decrease on the stress side will facilitate them developing faster, will make them participate in their therapies a lot more. They'll be a participant in it as opposed to having a fear factor. And by making this a home-like environment with toys around, different types of toys and different children, and having a bed like they have at home, it decreases that potential stressful environment for them so that they can have a peaceful time here.
When parents first come in, I think what really strikes them is that it's like a nursery school. We have murals on the wall, and we have cubbies for them to put their things. We have arts and crafts projects. We have lots of toys and books. And we are real kid-centered. We're not medical or equipment-centered or anything like that, and things are kid-size, and I think that's what really makes them feel more comfortable.
Through its transitional care program, Kangaroo Kids centers do more than provide a familial atmosphere where kids can be kids in spite of their illnesses. The service goes beyond administering to the medical needs of the patient, but has far-reaching effect on the family dynamics. Simply stated, family support is what Kangaroo Kids centers are all about.
Well, Kangaroo Kids, the Center for Fragile Children, is really the only one of its kind. It meets the needs of the medically fragile child. It allows them to develop to their fullest potential. But probably more important is that it provides an environment where kids can be kids.
When you start coming here, you realize that these people really care, and they're going to get the absolute best care. And that's been, for me, absolutely a lifesaver because, of, you know, like I said, it's stressful having a child who needs so much attention. And it just gives you the ability just to get back to being a family and to doing fun things instead of just always medical things and medical terms and, you know, all the medical stuff that goes along with having a child like this. It just gives you that freedom to let somebody else take care of that for a while and then to just get back to being a family.
As you've just seen, Kangaroo Kids Centers provide a transitional setting for medically fragile, technology-dependent children. The centers offer a warm, home-like environment, developmental programs, the latest medical equipment, and a compassionate staff of pediatric nurses. All this is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Kangaroo Kids Centers provide hospital-quality care and maximize your child's potential through their socialization and developmental programs. In order to see how much your child and your family will benefit from these programs, I urge you to contact the nearest Kangaroo Kids Center.